In addition to water, the women insisted on the need to take care of the children.
It's fine building jumbo planes, taking a ride on a cosmic train. Switch on summer from a slot machine. Just get what you want to if you want, 'cause you can get anything. I know we've come a long way, we're changing day to day, but tell me, where do the children play?
Everywhere we go, children are reaching out to each other, to the world, and to the children of the future.
But the kids that are around today, they're a lot more aware and conscious, socially conscious, and you know, they see the problems that are of their future, and they're ready to act. They want to participate. They want to be involved in helping their planet. There's a prophecy that I learned about. So the prophecy states that we're in a time when the world will be transformed, our culture will be transformed, when young people go to the government or people in power and speak their truth and ask those leaders to make the necessary changes that needs to happen.
Children, students, and today's youth are a vital part of the BARKA Burkina Consortium.
We're walking for water and carrying the load.
The Global Village class at Monument Mountain High School invited us to come in and talk about our work in Africa. They raised funds to add to BARKA's microfinance efforts.
I am pleased to give to you, we have made $187.72 are in here. 72 cents, somebody emptied their pockets. So here is, should I give it to you? All right.
Thank you.
And we look forward to hearing where the money goes and how the women respond and some of the initiatives that they've done already perhaps with some of the money.
Railroad Street Youth Project, a Berkshires-based youth group, has a local initiative for peace, which has begun communicating through email and pen pal packages with Peace's class in Fada.
A third grade class in Berkshire County studied the water cycle and integrated into their curriculum issues of water scarcity in West Africa. They raised funds for BARKA's well drilling effort.
It's going to come from the young people speaking up and speaking out. So that inspires me. I want to be a part of that prophecy.